Hello and welcome to WPKlik's YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about the excellent Instagram feed plugin, which allows you to link your Instagram feed directly into your WordPress website. The first thing to do is to head over to the WordPress plugin repository and then find, download and install the Instagram feed plugin. After that, the plugin will appear in your dashboard. Clicking on the plugin in your dashboard will open several options such as Configure, Customize, Display Your Feed and Support. The Configure tab contains some options you have to set before you start using the plugin. The Configure option lets you connect your Instagram account to your WordPress site. Just click on the blue button that says Connect an Instagram account. If you're already logged into your Instagram, then your feed will automatically connect to your WordPress website once you click this button. If you check the preserved settings when plugin is removed, you get to keep all your settings even after you delete the plugin. This way, if you end up installing the plugin again, all your options will already be set up. The Check for New Post Every option lets you decide how often you want your plugin cache cleaned, so your feed gets updated and displays any of your Instagram changes, if there are any. There is also a hashtag option that you can only use if you pay for pro version of the plugin. In case the button for connecting your account is not working, just press the button not working option and you will be able to get Instagram access token from the plugin creator's site, which you will then insert manually. The Customize tab contains all the settings that you need in order to completely adapt Instagram feed plugin to your needs. They are both basic and advanced settings, however, the advanced ones are reserved for premium users only. Here you get to set the feed width and height, background color, the number of photos that you want displayed, whether you want to show low, more and follow buttons, and more. After you're done with customizing Instagram feed to your liking, don't forget to click Save Changes. The Display Your Feed section allows you to decide where you want to place your Instagram feed by displaying the shortcode you will use for that purpose. The basic shortcode is Instagram-feed. If you put your code like this on your page, the Instagram feed that you will get is the one that you already set up using the Customize option. If, on the other hand, this isn't enough for you and you want to generate your own shortcode, you can find a list of all available shortcode options in the Display Your Feed tab. What you need to do is find the properties that you want your Instagram feed to have and just add them to the code, like we did in this example. This is a shortcode that you can add to your page. So, the allowed width of your Instagram feed will be 100% and it will contain 4 pictures, 2 columns, 1 column on smaller devices, and its header won't be displayed but it will contain a follow button. And here's what it looks like. Now, if you want to remove the load more button, you can add this shortcode. If you want to insert your Instagram feed as a widget, then you need to do it in the text field. And your Instagram feed widget will look like this. When it comes to your website's appearance on mobile devices, it is very important to mention the Disable Mobile Layout option. You can find it in the Customize tab. The purpose of this option is to set whether your mobile will display as many columns of Instagram pictures as the big screen does. Imagine, for example, the case where you have 6 columns in your footer. This looks great on big devices, but it appears way too small on mobile phones. In case the number of columns is the same both on big screens and mobile devices, this means that the Disable Mobile Layout option is checked. If you don't want your pictures arranged into columns but want them lined up one below the other, then just uncheck this field. If you plan to create your own shortcode, you can add Disable Mobile equals true to your code. This will have the same effect as the Check Uncheck field. And that's about it. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For more information about this topic, check out the description and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.